today we're going to be drawing a hibiscus. I love drawing these. They're so fun and easy to draw. I love them. They're really cute and, like I said, easy. Yes. And I'm going to teach you how to draw them. So, if you want to learn how to draw a hibiscus, whatever, then stay. Please. Thank you. Okay. So, you're going to draw... I'm going to draw a rough circle about the size of the other one. Maybe a little smaller. Mark the center and divide it into 5 sections. This, as I said, is going to be your petals. So now what you want to do is just go like a little bit outside of the guideline and just like do that. And you're going to do that on each petal going into the guideline. Oh no, I made a mark. Okay. And now I'm just going to do that for each and every one of the petals. Comment down below if you like hibiscuses. Hibiscus guy. I never learned how to pronounce it right. And comment what your favorite flower is. I said this in the last video, but nobody answered me. So I want to know what's your favorite flower. Mine's a rose, but I said in the last video that I didn't know how to draw roses. So, okay, now we have our rough guidelines. It's like something like this. Okay. And now what you're gonna do is erase here. Let me find my needles. You're gonna erase. Okay, erase lightly. If you don't have a kneaded eraser, that's fine. If you want me to show you how to make one from scratch, then with using just an eraser, then I will show you. So you can you still see that? Let's see. Yeah, you can still see that. Okay. So now, what you're gonna do? I'm looking at my other one. I don't know. I learned how to do this on Skillshare, which is a really good place to learn how to do things. Not sponsored. Yes. You're gonna draw a line from the bottom-ish this petal and to like go here. And how you're going to make the petal is you're just going to do wavy lines. Do not have to be perfect. And you're going to do that. And then other petal. And yes. You're going to stop right there. I know I didn't stop right there. Okay. And now this petal. Petal is going to come out. And then it's going to do the same wavy random ones. Okay, why? Okay. And now we're going to just go from right here and just make a wavy one. Go from the middle again. I know, go over here. Sorry. I'm losing my mind. Stop coming. Here, I need to move up. Sorry. Okay. Let's do lines. More petals. And perfect. Not my flowers. That's okay. Flowers are never perfect. Erase all your mistakes. Like my Like that. I need to click something like this. I keep drifting out of focus. Okay, I'm just... Okay. There we go. And now, we're going... Just keep petals. Okay. And maybe go over them a little bit darker. Because that's what I like to differentiate the petals from, like, this little middle part that has a bunch of lines. Oh my gosh, why am I so out of focus? Out of the screen. Starling. I've never gotten what to say when I am drawing, so also comment down below what I should talk about during these awkward times when I'm just drawing. Okay, and now we are going, let's focus on one petal. You're just going to pick a random spot and just go all the way down. All the way down. And do a couple of these lines. And they don't have to be evenly spaced like these. And now you're going to focus on this part right here. You want the majority of the lines to be down here and make them more together. And you can go further. You can go further. Okay, and now go to the top of the petal and you're going to do some lines but not as crowded as the bottom. Short, big, that looks okay. I am not liking this doing that. Just trust in the process. Okay. You just gotta trust in the process. I hate it, but it's fine, I guess. Trust in the process. And then you're gonna do the same thing for each of the petals. Okay, I'm very sorry for the out of focus, for the out of camera-ness, and yes, you're probably wondering, well, maybe you aren't, but you might be wondering, what about the little stem thingy? Not to worry, person, I don't know. I should have told you this before, but I forgot. So, you're going to just, like, erase what you have done. If you're using a Sharpie, I'm so sorry. Or a permanent marker or a pen, you're going to just erase a little bit in the middle. And just make a little stem thingy. Going pretty tall up. That was the first mistake I made when I first drew this, is I made it way too short. And it did not look like a hibiscus, whatever, I don't know how to say. So, just two little lines up from the very middle, and now, I'm gonna erase this a little bit. Okay, and you're going to just, sorry, you're going to do some little teeny lines in all different directions. Just in all different directions. Don't worry. All different directions. And now you're going to do a couple little oval shapes. You can see that. little oval shape at the top. And your hibiscus is practically done. I just need to fix a couple little mistakes that I erased accidentally. And yeah, it's done. If you want to go over this with pen and do it, I feel like just keeping mine in pencil for now. And yeah, that's my hibiscus tutorial. I hope you liked it. And full credit goes to, I forgot his or her name, because they didn't really talk in the class that I took. But yes, full credit goes to them, and I will see you guys later. Oh yes, consider subscribing. Consider subscribing. Like, all is well. You don't need to consider liking, because, okay, I'm just embarrassing myself now. So, I better go. Goodbye.